Good evening. This is Adam Carolla from Loveline. Please, settle down. Please, with the applause, settle. Oh, you're embarrassing me. Please, settle down. Please. I'm sorry I can't be with you today on this great event. As you know, I've been there the last couple of years, and work does not permit me to... All right. Man, I screwed that up already. Do you like that?
Yeah, I like that.
Maybe we should try that in a...
A wider shot would be better.
And you can just, Hello, this is Adam Carolla from Loveline. Thank you. Thank you. You're too kind. Thank you very much. Thank you. I love you all. Thank you. Okay. I can't be with you today in person, although I wish I could. It's a great event, and WHFS is a great station. My love to all those involved. And now it is my pleasure to bring out Scott Weiland. Hello there. This is Adam Carolla from Loveline. First, I want to thank all my Washington, D.C. buddies and WHFS for putting up with us, me, Drew, and the show for as many years as we've been on. We truly do appreciate it. Now, I can't be with you today, but we thought we'd let you have a little look around the Loveline studio. This is our environment. This is our hellhole, if you will. Over here, you can see the lovely rendition of me yelling the F word that Dickie from the Boss Tones scrabbled out when he was in here some months back. Of course, the Mahalo from Elvis and the Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five record album, which is up there for no apparent reason. Engineer Mike is doing a wonderful job mining the camera. Drew is somewhere else as usual. And without any further ado, I'd like to bring out Scott Weiland. Hello there. This is Adam Carolla from Loveline. I'm sorry I can't be with you today, but we do truly appreciate the support of all the WHFS fans and management that has put up with us over the years. You truly are our favorite affiliate. I'm here in the Loveline studio, and I thought it might be fun if you could get a look or a glimpse at the hellhole that we're forced to work in on a nightly basis. That's Engineer Mike behind the camera. Give a wave, Mike. Yes. Straight down is where my cohort, Dr. Drew, would sit. I'm sitting where I would sit. Through that glass would be producer Ann, Sherry, and, of course, the cameraman, Engineer Mike, not to mention phone screener Lisa. Some of the wonderful artwork that adorns the Loveline studio is the picture that Dickie from the Boss Tones drew of me yelling the F word on the air, as I'm known to do on occasion. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed the concert up until this point, and I know you're going to keep on enjoying it, because it is my pleasure to bring out Scott Weiland. Thank you, and enjoy. Hello there, this is Adam Carolla from Loveline. Thank you. Thank you, you're too kind. Although I can't be there in person today, and I wish I could, because I do love WHFS, and I do love this concert, I thought it'd be fun to give you a little remote... I screwed that up. Try it again. can cue me when you want the beer. Hi, it's Adam Carolla from Loveline. Thank you. Thank you. You're too kind. Although I can't be at your wonderful event in person, and I was there the last 2 years, although I can't remember it, I thought it'd be nice to give you this little video greeting. I'm sitting in the Loveline studio. This is the hell we call home. This is where the magic works. Engineer Mike is behind the camera. Wave hi, Mike. Give a quick panorama around the studio so you can get a good idea for how this works. Over there, to Engineer Mike's right, is a picture that the fabulous Dickie from the Boss Tones drew us. It's a real-life depiction of one of my many outbursts on the air when I yelled the F-word inadvertently. Through that glass is a nameless engineer. Don't pay any attention to him. Dr. Drew, well, he sits straight down, and of course, I'm sitting on my throne. Again, we appreciate the support, and without any further ado, I'd like to bring out Scott Weiland. You going? Hi, this is Adam Carolla from Loveline. I'm standing inside the Westwood One bathroom right now, shaking the dew off the lily. I'm sorry I couldn't be with you today. It is a wonderful event. You know how sometimes you get that shiver thing right after you take a whiz? Anyway, I love WHFS, and I really wish I could have been there in person today. But I can't. It's still my pleasure, though, to bring out the fabulous Scott Weiland. Well, what have we here? Hi, this is Adam Carolla from Loveline. And although I can't be there in person today...
I screwed up. I put it down too far.
That's all right.
I didn't use the proper seal. All right. You good? You okay, though?
Mm-hmm. Well, what a surprise. Hi. This is Adam Carolla from Loveline, and although I can't be there in person today, I do want to take this opportunity to thank you and WHFS for all this... Oh. All this...
We got our own blooper reel! Yes.
Well, what a surprise. Hello, this is Adam Carolla from Loveline, and although I can't be there in person today, I do want to take this opportunity to thank you and WHFS for all the support you've given the show over the years. So, without any further ado, Scott Weiland. We're going to have Republica in, and then not tonight, but later in the week, Primus, The Descendants, Sir Mix-a-Lot, the man who sings about Big Butts.
You've been saying he's coming for 2 weeks now.
I'm excited. He's like Santa. And Krista Miller from the Drew Carey Show. And Drew, I know you're a big fan of the Drew Carey Show. Not because you share the same name, but it's fun. Wait till she comes in. Drew will have never seen that. That's the way. All right, we ready to go?
Please, let's go.
Samantha, 14, you're on Loveline.
Hi.
Hey.
Okay. My problem is, this summer I lost my virginity to a guy who's 20 years old and he used to be my neighbor.
Uh-huh.
He came back here this summer. He left last year about, like, in November. And he came back here this summer, and we just kind of, like, you know, slept together. And I don't know if I should tell him that he was my first or not.
Do you still have a relationship with him?
Well, I don't really have any contact with him now because he moved back to Nebraska, and I live here in Minnesota.
Uh-huh. How old is this guy?
He's 20.
Oh. Oh, for Christ's sake. You're a rodeo clown. Maybe I want to eat fire. Maybe I want to have a lesbian experience. Maybe this. Maybe I want to try heroin. My advice to all those people who maybe, you don't have to necessarily go out and try it.
Well, that,
I'm
that in
take
fact,
a little bit of time.
That in fact, at that age, when you try these things, it adds to the pain and confusion.
Right. Okay. Thank you.
I want to try being a street person.
Please, everyone says, no, hold on. Everyone makes as much noise as you want. It's okay. Everyone's creeping around in here. Go ahead. Please. Here, I'll knock around the mic a little. There we go. All right. Now everyone's comfortable. Republica just strolled in here, and they were creeping around like church mice, and it was very distracting. I'd rather them just vomit on something.
Like everyone else does here.
All right, so we have Saffron, Johnny, and Tim all from...
Pennywise you were talking about, was it?
No.
Pennywise did do that, though. Yeah.
Phone number, Loveline Kitties, 1-800-LOVE-191, fax number 310-854-4455. Republica has themselves a CD out. They are in studio tonight. That CD is called Republica. On that CD is a song called Ready to Go, and it goes a little something like this. Republica off of their CD Republica, which has not been out too long, right? It just came out.
July the 30th, I think it hit the shelves.
Okay. So if you haven't seen it, if you haven't found it, if you haven't gotten into it yet, go do that.
We've been using the bed for this for a long time, haven't we?
Yes, we've been using the music bed going in, what, in and out of commercials or something?
Mike? Out of commercials.
Yeah. All right.
Out of commercials.
Whatever. We've been hearing the Ready to Go anthem and not really knowing. But as soon as it fired up, Drew went, oh, yeah.
I like that song.
Now, why? Drew, do you like it because you've heard the whole song on K-Rock?
I've heard the whole song on K-Rock, and it probably because it was familiar to me when I heard it, I started liking it, and then I still like it.
It's kind of weird. You become like a Pavlovian dog. I mean, I'll be driving down the freeway on a Saturday night in the middle of the night, and I'll hear the beginning guitar riff of a song that we use to come out of a commercial, and all of a sudden I'll be like, I'll be in the studio.
Yeah,
it'll be like, oh, it's time to go. And then I'll careen into a truckload of illegal aliens as they're coming across the border, and the highway patrol has to clean up everything. Now,
with their sticks.
You guys are cleaning up everything with their sticks. Please, Drew, send those letters to Dr. Drew. We're just talking outside that you guys are touring the U.S., and this is your first U.S. tour. And you get to go to all the garden spots, right?
All the lovely places, yeah.
But you're probably, I mean, I've lived in the United States my entire life, and you guys will see more of it in 6 months than I have my entire life.
Well, we definitely.
See the inside of the bus quite a lot, which is, and we arrive at venues and go in and do the sound check, go to a hotel, back to do the...
Are you guys struck by how different? I mean, to me, each part of the country is so different. I wonder if you're from the outside, if those differences are as glaring.
They are, yes. If you turn up somewhere, like our bus broke down in Miami, Oklahoma, which is like the middle of absolutely nowhere. It's one strip of like dodgy motels, shops that are all shut, and churches.
I got video.
What were we doing 3 seconds before the video started up here?
And how, in the other 85% of the time, you were right, I'm guessing.
Oh, absolutely.
And as far as writing, as far as dialogue goes, because she has such a distinctive voice, and I don't mean
okay.
the sound of her voice, but
no.
I mean,
oh yeah, this is cool.
Just to use her words.
This is good video.
You just basically have to learn to write. Like
that's exactly what you have to do. When you sign on to a show, you have to get to know the voice of all the characters. You have to know Jackie's voice, Roseanne's voice, and
brought to you by this station, the Advertising Council, and the American Red Cross.